and understanding, the freedom in knowing the gravitational call to the stars, the refinement necessary to keep them from colliding, the knowledge that our story isn't precautionary tales or careless whispers. Your systems will be measured, their void put on display. We are the color born of a galaxy in darkness, black excellence, the fourth element, the fourth element.
Citizens, how's your spirit? Mine, a mess. I decided to go live this evening because I was supposed to go live at 9:30. So let's just be between 9:30 and 10. That's for starters. And then the second thing being I woke up from my nap late, and then I caught the tail end of Brother We Unlock's conversation, about Black women not being the problem and that fellas were. And I thought, you know, I just saw this video, so I should probably share what I learned today. No, Black women aren't a problem, yet there is a problem for Black women. And we need to talk about it. But you know me, you guys, we're going to do theme songs. We're going to do some music. We got to get a medicated moment. We're going to check in with your spirit. So first things first, let's do that. How's your spirit? What's going on in your world? Why are you up this time of night? Me? It's the time of night that I'm supposed to be up medicating, and I would have been live anyway. So I figured, well, JP, go ahead and get back into the routine of doing that thing that you do, Chicky Poo. You know, so ta-da, here I be. I know, don't judge me too much, you guys. I'm gonna get my act right, get myself together. Please, as you come in, make sure that you like, share, subscribe. Let's get the conversation going and make sure that we're a little further down the road here. Shout out to everybody who is watching from the clouds. I appreciate you. Sorry, you guys. I'm getting my little discombobulated self together. Told y'all, it's still getting used to some of these things. You know, it's a month away, we'll do that to you. It's absolutely bonkers. Absolutely bonkers. But anyway. All right, so got one more thing to do, and then I am all set. All right. So, first things first, you have a theme song? I got this one. This one was playing in the background, and I actually love this song. It's hard for me to believe that Neo was such a youngin' back in the day. Oh, my bad, you guys. I was also doing something else that I forgot. Hold on. Let me get my act right together and get this done. Sorry. I mean, apologies for not being more prepared. As I get back into the routine of doing this, though, I guarantee you that this will not continue to be an issue. Why am I up? Medication time. All right, so let's get my goofy self back over here. Ta-da, here I be. And we are going to, what up in my bag? Ta-da. Okay, so first things first, you know how it is. First 5 minutes, we're going to talk about the medicated moment. So today's medicated moment is brought to us by Kush Mints. This one is 21.56% THC. Check that out. See that? Oh, look at the gorgeousity on that bud, y'all. I'm trying to get right up into my little Samsung camera. Look at that. Look at that. It's nice. It's dense. It's not heavy, but it's definitely moist. It's got a nice green smell to it. Still fairly fresh. Which this particular dispensary tends to sell things in, not tend, this particular dispensary sells things in the pack. So you don't get to go in and look at the product like you do in some dispensaries. So anyway, we're going to do that. Like I said, this one's 21% THC Kushman. So we're going to be, you know, in a happy, uplifted mood, relax the muscles. It is an indica dominant strain. So we will be able to get some rest later on. There might be some couch luck that pushes up on us sooner than later. So first thing, you guys, I think I left my grinder inside. I did. Pause for my cause. Okay, I'm back. In the meantime, let's get back into this theme song. Like I said, this one's the one I've been listening to. I'm so shocked to believe, when I look at the picture of Neo on this album cover, I'm like, oh my God, he was such a baby. And to believe what he's singing about, y'all. But anyway, you're in the clouds, you're out there, you're up late. That's the theme song.
I love to watch the faces that you make. Holding your hips,
packed right in the grinder.
Your eyes and bite your lip.
I can't see you.
So might I suggest
a change? Then grind it
up.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Please don't move me strange for what but
say you. Beautiful here.
Don't think me strange.
You know anything about me by now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a freak.
Just follow my lead.
Oh, we're just gonna grind it up. Grinders are great for bowls and
joints.
I
want
to get a nice
baby tonight.
Yeah.
Watch me do the nasty.
All right, so we've got our bud ground up. Ta-da! We're gonna add it right into the bowl. You should know, again, we talked about this some time ago, medical marijuana is not covered by insurance. So every medical cannabis patient that you meet, they're coming out of pocket above and beyond their other medical expenses in order to be able to treat the ailments that they have. Where someone can spend $5 with an insurance card and go and get, you know, 90 days worth of pain medication. You can't do that. You can't even purchase 30 days of medical marijuana outright without there being a situation. So yeah, that's the reason why I get on camera and I talk to you about cannabis and I smoke and so on and so forth. And I share with other people and I do the medicated moments in the shorts and I do cannabis consulting because people truly don't understand, one, that it's an herb, it is medicine like your food is. And two, that we can do, that people are really out here trying to do the right thing, the best thing for them when it comes to taking care of their medical needs, because medical marijuana is natural and they have to be sure of that before they can sell it to you as a medication. So it's something for you to consider. Right now, since I am, you know, doing that thing and it is the end of the month, let's just go ahead and make it the first of the month. And do a little Bone Thugs and Harmony when I get my life right. Ta-da! Where is my
porch.
Having a wonderful day, and I won't fight with my wife. This is the first of the month, and I'll be smoking, joking.
That was my fault. Sorry, guys.
Gonna give us a play, yo. Double up, nigga, what you need? We got weed to get me your beat. Beat for the green leaf. Give it up for the first to show, but it lay low. Because the pump won't creep when it rolls so low. Break if you can't get away, but it's toast that, yeah, yo. Keep your bankroll. Yeah. We're having a celebration. Love to stay high. It'll leave when it's time to grind. I'm down for mine. Crime after crime. When the creep to the bag, cause mob on the grill. If we got the food, oh. You know it's the first of the month. And my nigga, we chills for real.
Wake up. It's the first of the month.
She said I'm really gonna get in my stance. Watch I make sure no one snatches my chain. Nigga, that's the real man. Sold to the man and put it up in the mid pocket. So let me hit it and land it down. To give me a cup of all that coffee. Why they no fucking ride that reader? Hop on the 10 to the clip. Ready to get him up with him. It feels in the catch that gun. Man, I gotta get there. Flair, holler. Ain't clear, got much to offer. Whatever we don't not net free. I'll open the clock lock for some dollars. So get a bag of dope and a quarter out.
All right. Three more good hits in. Gotta get the smoke going through the stream. That's the important thing. Lungs, oxygen, cough. Hey, Razik, how's your spirit? I will just a second. Excuse me. Ooh, have mercy. You gonna make me drop the link? I can't even have a conversation first. Okay, I got you. Yes, sir. Fair enough. Let me drop the link. I think I sent you the... There you go, sir. I have videos to show you this time, too. Excuse me. Let me get this other song going real quick. Ta-da. Why you mad, though? I enjoy my medication. I use it wisely as I have exercised regularly every 4 to 6 hours. So why you all why you treating me that way? That's all I want to know. Why you treating me that way?
Sitting on the floor to be a hey, things is feeling good today.
So what the flow up?
Sitting on the floor and the second like whoa, well, everybody smoke they own bug.
Good old hey, how you doing?
Back and roll, back to the freak that's on the road. Sometimes I wonder when I'm
except the smell.
Smoking high all by myself.
Okay, y'all. Let me get my ass right. Busted. You know how dads can be. Peace for Zeke. How's your spirit?
Yo. Yeah.
I hear you just fine. What's going on, gentlemen?
Hey, shit. Yeah, I was over there. No, I was listening to a crazy ass conversation with Anton got the Fight Club jumping.
That's right.
And them motherfuckers over there already like they haven't even been going at it for an hour and they're already cursing each other out over some silly shit. I thought it was kind of like common sense. Girl was up there with angry man. He's I think he's still up there. Yeah, he is.
Have you talked to a woman in a certain way that?
Yeah, he's up there now. Yeah, fatty, Aaron, angry man, Auntie Jay, Sharon.
Hmm.
Yeah, Daryl up there. Daryl up there. You know what I'm saying?
Doing Daryl.
doing his little 1-2 step, I guess you could say.
He said 1-2 step. Okay. It's not something that I watch. Like I said, you know me, I'm not really interested in seeing my folks go at it for absolutely no reason. You can watch that pretty much anywhere.
Sometimes the convos be kind of interesting, but you know, when it's just kind of like random, and a lot of times, in this particular case, I don't think the conversation was genuinely held because some people were serious and you could kind of tell others were kind of joking and maybe but it is what it is.
Gotcha. Okay. I was over on, I got up late, first of all. excuse me, I had a couple of extra counseling sessions today that I didn't intend upon. And then when I woke up, I usually will check to see who else is on. And if it's something that a conversation that I can get into, sometimes I'll just join that. But since I haven't been live with my own community for a while, and we on lock had some family things going on. I said I just decided to go live. But he was having a conversation over there on his channel about single Black mothers not being the problem, and that Black men were the problem. And I was like, yeah, nah, brother. We need to have a real conversation because that's the untruth right there. And in fact, single Black mothers and their children are most likely to be evicted. And that's what I was getting ready to show here in a bit. But, I start with theme songs everywhere I am because music is my medium. It's my motivator. It keeps me from feeling all 47 of them years. We were doing that. So do you have a theme song this evening?
Yes. Yeah. I do. It definitely ain't going to be that retrograde shit y'all like or you're listening to. But
sorry,
I definitely. Oh, yeah.
I don't know what that
means. You heard me loud and clear.
Yeah. So disrespectful. What's your theme song?
Oh my God! You go with that disrespectful.
Wait,
shit.
You just gonna decide that I'm gonna feel some type of way, but that's not disrespectful.
I don't deal with feelings. Like feelings don't matter to me. Like that's look. Before I give you my theme song, right? And I've told you this over and over. Like men don't feel, yo. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, true indeed, we may have, emotions as far as, like, anger and aggravation, frustration, upset, angry. You know what I'm saying? It's not, like, I don't understand that type of logic. So, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not going to discredit you and, or, you know what I'm saying, just women in general, because I know when women talk, they always say, well, I feel like, you know what I'm saying? And I, that's a non-quantifiable thing. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, and, you know, I'm pretty sure we'll dive deeper. You know what I'm saying? But in the meantime, well, go ahead.
We'll have the feelings conversation, but we have to do it when Big Rig can join, because me and Big Rig have already gone round and round about the feelings. And I had to admit to him that I recognize having feelings, yet I'm autistic, so I don't get feelings in that way. I just put it there because I'm not trying to go with the rest of this shit right now. Anyway, I don't get into my feels the way that other people do. Reggie, the gentleman who was on with us yesterday, he would tell you that as well, because he thought I was really cold. It's not that. I don't hang on to feelings. I got too much shit to do in this life. You say that women aren't built to lead. Okay, fine. Yet I've had to, thus I have that type of mindset. But I say all that to say, me and Big Rig have gone round and round about feels. So before I get into it with you, I'm gonna let you talk to him about it. But what's your theme song?
You know, I'm very candid and open, you know what I'm saying, to having that, you know what I'm saying, combo with anybody. And I stand 10 toes, you know what I'm saying, on that. But anyway, my song is a song by 38 Special and Ransom called Last Gasp.
I listened to this the other day. I'll have to listen to it again.
Oh, you did hear it?
Mm-hmm. When you sent it to me,
I want to see the best side.
Bye.
Hey, Miss Quantum. Can you hear it okay?
Yes.
Niggas say they outside, but with no place to go. They say, Rand, you look young. They see in my face a glow that resembles the greats before. Nas, Big Face, and Hov. I got a ways to go, but don't you try to give me them flowers that took a day to grow. See me, I let them haters know. And I tell my people around me, I'm trying to feed you, gon' bleed if you take your plate to go. No. I wanna see the best side of me, but money changes niggas like Barry. And now they telling lies to me. Addicted to the life with no sobriety. I had some niggas that was guiding me violently. Now I get teary-eyed when my daughter says bye to me. Silently, I keep it all inside of me, cause this is how I gotta be.
I wanna see the best side.
Yeah. I hope you seeing what is what. Was always full of hatred, couldn't love enough. That's why I said enough's enough. But those who bet against me, I tell them niggas, let's double up. Deal a card, shuffle up. Pioneers spilling your heart on tracks and they shut them up. First one through the wall is always gonna get bloodied up. Mm-hmm. And now this runner up is about to run it up. Too bad y'all niggas run is up. Niggas drunk the Kool-Aid, but it's too late, cause most of these rapping niggas gon' want a cup. You never seen me buddied up when niggas ain't the same cloth. Taking pics, hugging up, telling stories that ain't yours. You ain't never blow your gun clean, blood off a stained floor. Yeah, you might be holding one, but we ain't on the same course. I'm wrapping up a large peak, headed to the main source. Some crackers in a RV with Berettas and some chainsaws. That's why I spent this pain for. For niggas locked up and she say it ain't yours. Brother dead on the same call, another death got your brain paused. We remain floored, can't afford to weather the storm, cause even the rain pour. Now we not the same dog, please let me explain, Lord. If I'm in a crowd of niggas, who you think they gon' aim for? Yeah, yours truly. To all these fake rappers who swear that war's a movie, I clear the walls of juvie, your fearless bars don't move me. You playing a game, prepared for call of duty. The opps saying my name, I hear the calls of duty. Them in chains, I swear them laws are spooky, but I hear the guards as groupies. They tell me this my last gasp. I take a deep breath and reassess. I'm in the mirror working on my last laugh.
I'm gonna stop it right there so I don't get a copyright strike. I like it. It makes you seem
fine.
Quantum, do you have a theme song for me in the chat? Do you have a decent, I'm sorry, excuse me, I did not mean to say that that way. Do you have a song about mothers that you like, Razik?
Nah, I don't.
No?
Nope.
Early on, and I've been in streaming on YouTube now for almost a year, for a year come next month. And that was one of the first things that I said in this space, was that I wanted more mothers to have what I had, and you know, as far as the way that my sons talk to me and speak about me to others, the way that I speak about my mother. And I'm just seeing so much less, I'm seeing that less and less as I get older. And that's someone saying that who, you know, I owned a daycare for a while. I worked in high schools in the last 10 years. I worked in colleges in the last 10 years. And these young adults of all walks of life, male, female, presenting, whatever you want to call it, so many of them are angry with their mothers. It can't be a, what's the word? It can't be a fluke. It can't be a coincidence, right? There's got to be something going on. So, like I said, when I saw We Unlocks thing today, I was like, nah, we need to have this conversation. But the reason why I do the theme songs is because I'm not coming here. I know you feel like they should be shamed, which is fine. And to some degree, some of them I do believe should too. Yet, shaming isn't going to get us forward, right? So I play some music, smoke. I have to medicate anyway.
I don't agree. But
why?
You know, shaming is what keeps order. You know what I'm saying? We grew up in a time where, you know what I'm saying, shaming was relevant. You know what I'm saying? It kept, you know, it keeps people at bay. You know what I'm saying? Knowing that, you know, saying the wrong thing can get you punched in the mouth or slapped or even killed. You know what I'm saying? And I say that because, you know, now you have women with enough gall to tell another man to, you know what I'm saying, suck her dick. You know what I'm saying? In a heinous, you know what I'm saying, manner. And a woman should never, you know, form her lips to say such, you know, vulgar shit. You know what I'm saying? So and even then, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, when people were fat, you know what I'm saying? They were called, yo, you fat. When motherfuckers is ugly, they get told, yo, you ugly. Motherfuckers is broke, you get told you broke. If you a liar, you get told you a liar. You a bitch, you get told you a bitch. You a hater, you get told you a hater. I mean, I can give 1,000 more examples of this. Shaming is needed. And getting away from shaming is not helping us. You know what I'm saying? Like I told you this numerous times before. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers need to be shamed. They need to be put out there in a manner, you know what I'm saying, to where it brings, you know, resentment. You know what I'm saying? For people to realize that your actions and the things that you do, not only upon yourself, but when you involve children, when you involve other people in the world, your actions affect those of others. Shaming is very necessary. It is a necessary evil that must exist in order to create order, dissonance, you know, a certain level of correspondence, you know what I'm saying, particularly between the sexes, between men and women. See, us as men, we understand this, which is why, you know, there's always, and, you know, Kevin Samuels spoke about this as well before he passed. But he used to say, he was like, you know, when men argue and debate like amongst us. We don't say certain things to each other as men because we know that there's always an invisible line of violence at all times. At all times.
Okay.
This is why, you know what I'm saying, you don't hear men telling other men, yo, suck my dick, you hoe ass, or your nigga, unless it's meant, you know what I'm saying, to incite violence.
So does the science then not say that women move the same way amongst women?
No, it doesn't. You women are agreeable in nature. You know what I'm saying? Which is why Yes. Y'all agree. An overwhelmingly majority of all women agree with each other, which is why the sister code, quote unquote, has always came into play.
Hey, Big Rig. Y'all got bro code. I don't know about that one.
The bro code is different. And you know what I'm saying? Like, let me tell you something, yo. You women have got to stop comparing yourselves to us. We don't play by the same rules. Our bro code is different. Our bro code entails street shit, yo. Like, not snitching, not ratting, not doing no homo shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, not lying on your dick. That's our bro code. You know what I'm saying? Like, you used to always hear when niggas used to say money over, you know what I'm saying, MOB. You know what I'm saying? You know, money over hitches.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? The sister code is when you women agree with each other in a manner and in certain matters where you know, you know what I'm saying, it's morally wrong. Like, for example, the video I had gave you, you know what I'm saying, earlier, there were women in the comments agreeing with her actions. That's the sister code. When, from an observable reality, you have two eyes and two ears, you have a brain, and you can clearly see that those actions are not conducive to anybody, not even herself. But yet women in the comments, overwhelmingly, almost all of them, you go, girl, I mean, well, I don't see, she no lies chosen. She's living her truth and blah, blah, blah. All of this bullshit. It's sad, yo. It's sad.
That to me was, Reggie called me and we talked about it. That was just one of the most trashy things that I've seen. It's one of the clips that I intend on playing today, but you see Big Rig in the chat because he know when I talk about feelings, I told him, y'all didn't have that conversation.
Big Rig, join up, man. We got some shit to discuss, homie. Join up, man. We got some shit to discuss tonight, nigga.
We do, because I got a couple of videos to show you. Last night when I was on, it was my first night back in a while. And so I figured I'd do time, but we always do music over here. And so I still got to get some music done. I got to get medicated here in the next 12 minutes. I also have to go for a potty break. Yes, even over here, I still have to take potty breaks. Deal with it. It is what it is. So do you have another theme song in the meantime, sir?
Yes. Play Ransom. The name of the song is called The Mystery.
Ransom Mystery. See, Big Rig don't let me know. He's supposed to be ready whenever I'm ready, Big Rig. You know this.
Big Rig, join up, bro. Where you at, man?
He said his phone is low. He do me like that, but it's okay. Hey, I'll
man,
be back.
Find you a charger and join up, okay. Home.
So, The Mystery or Misery?
Yeah.
I'm just...
Nah, okay. The Mystery.
Thank you. Just wanted to be sure. Ta-da.
Doubt you know a nigga that's vivid like them. Everything that's under that bridge water, these niggas Vikings. Turn your back on the backstabber, they twist the knife in. Never worth more than that pool of blood that you dripped your life in. Yeah, nigga, this shit is frightening, quick as lightning. Handguns registered like the fist of Tyson's. Niggas chatter but never budge on these subjects. You suspects sending those rough threats all in your subtext. So what's next? How you make niggas bleed on your Twitter feed? Nigga, please, guess we gon' have to agree to disagree. That's grown man shit, the bro hand whip. You know Rancic, I choke him with the Conan grip. That's ifs or buts, I will choke slam shit. I clean them up, he's seen enough. That's when the program switch. Beloved, it's a must that we rise above this. We ain't brothers, but the God that created us gotta love us. What you saying? Say what you feel, niggas. We ain't just some field niggas. Mean what you say, player. We don't play it safe, hater. Say what you want about me, y'all people, let's fuck without me. It ain't nothing as long as you saying something. No squad around me, I need my space like the stars around me. Scar your bounty, I'm just keeping it cordial cause God has found me, hard to doubt me. I used to lock in for them guards to count me. Word to bundles, I'm avenging his death like I'm Robert Downey. Father crown me, I'm born to be king. My pain is known, change your tone. I ain't just spitting no scene from the Game of Thrones. Flame the chrome, see how corners get played in the danger zone. This ain't a poem, spit it all from a heart that was made of stone. Came to Rome. That just means I'm talking that grease shit. Swerve your truck on the street shit. Burners tucked in your fleece shit. Played it for 7 days, but your album's still on some weak shit. I never see the vision from niggas who never seen shit. Lil' nigga that's transparent, posing pics, hoes with dicks. Let me talk to that transparent, true or false.
Okay.
Some niggas get lost.
I like it. Again, it's deep. My curiosity, because, you know, I'm difficult, and it's coming up on midnight in the desert. What's a love song from Zeke to?
You asking the wrong. Oh, you nigga. I don't deal with that shit. Go ahead.
I realized when I typed that I you know, that probably wasn't the best way to go about it. So let me ask in a different way. When attempting to seduce a young lady, what's a song that you would choose?
You know what? I've never been asked that before. I don't know. I mean, I don't, like, I'm not that dude. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not no R&B cat, yo. Like, I don't have one.
So do you just hum in her ear, Razik? What the fuck?
No, I mean, whatever she like to play. You know what I'm saying? But you asking me, like, I don't have one.
Okay, sorry. Excuse me just 1 second. That one threw me. I have to admit, I had not... I kind of anticipated there being some answer, like, well, you know, at least this song right here get me, you know, I at least know I can talk to her on this song or something along them lines, some Charlie Wilson something. But okay, fair enough.
Hey, look, I wish I could have one. I don't have one. I don't listen to R&B. I don't like R&B. You know what I'm saying? Like, nah. You know what I'm saying? At all.
Okay, what styles of music do you like?
I mean, I you hear it. I mean, you want to hear one more example?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, hey, there's someone in the back. No, that's you. Okay, my bad. That's my other one. Okay, what's another one?
Play 38 Special by myself.
38 Special on the rights to this live stream right here. All right, here we go.
Is this music you listen to get out of a funk?
My bottle empty. Yeah. I drunk it all by myself. My bitch left, so now I'm all by myself. My money up. I'm about to count it by myself. And if I lose it all now, I won't cry for help. My bottle empty, I drunk it all by myself. My bitch left, so now I'm all by myself. My money up, I'm about to count it by myself. And if I lose it all now, I won't cry for help. I had to mention, stay away from folks with bad intentions. Faggot niggas and broke hoes that act expensive. I don't have time, cause grinding how I'd rather spend it. I manage businesses, but suffer from a lack of friendships. Fuck niggas, 90% of them retards. Deny me when I presented propositions to eat hard. Y'all hate, now y'all hopping in cheap calls. Mixing business with feelings, consequences and rewards. Y'all hear me? Yeah, I said it sincerely. Y'all put rings on these bitches that should never be married. Watch your close friends, they keep they jealousy. Till that chip on they shoulder get too heavy to carry. They
this try to hide minutes. It,
but it's still in their soul. Only a matter of time for their feelings exposed. Damn, say it to you, tell true feelings to hoes. And these ain't bad bitches, these the ones still in clothes. My bottle empty, I drunk it all by myself. My bitch left, so now I'm all by myself. My money up, I'm about to count it by myself. And if I lose it all now, I won't cry for help. My bottle empty, okay. I drunk it all by myself. My bitch left, so now I'm all by myself. My money up, I'm about to count it by myself. And if I lose it all now, I won't cry for help.
Good.
Okay, one question, and then we're gonna get into playing butterflies for the cupcakers in the chat. Do you believe that music affects your mindset? Hello.
I was saying, no, I don't agree.
You don't believe that? Okay.
Nah, I was gonna say, music is relatable to them and me, meaning like, I listen to music that reflects, you know what I'm saying, me, and like the things that I've been through. So, almost everything I hear or I listen to is like street shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, running the streets, being locked up, you know what I'm saying? Like the mindset that comes along with that, learning how to cope, looking at the world, you know what I'm saying? Differently, looking at people for who they are. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Like, but go ahead, my fault. Go ahead.
No, I hear you. And we both agree, because we've already said this. Now, if I'm wrong, then correct me. But we both agree that overconsumption is an issue for people. Why isn't repeatedly listening to this type of music overconsumption?
Well, I mean, and again, I don't expect, you know what I'm saying, everybody to, you know, look at it the same way I do. However, you know, if just in those three songs and what you hear or what you have heard, you know what I'm saying? If I was overly consumed by what I was listening to, I would go right back into Jimson the Street. I wouldn't want to learn anything else. I wouldn't be reading the books. I wouldn't be learning about the stock market. I wouldn't have a business. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't be driving trucks. You know what I'm saying? Like, I would still be, quote unquote, a jailbird. You know what I'm saying?
Her.
You know, so, I'm sorry, go ahead.
I suppose, and in those songs, I hear that. I hear deep reflection. I hear a need to move forward with your purpose. I don't hear an addressing of women in a positive light.
And I'm only saying that to say that if we're continuously consuming either things that don't include women or have a negative connotation towards women, that's the same as us continuously eating jelly donuts when we know they're not good for us, right?
Well, I hate to break it to you, JP, but CNN breaking news.
Uh-oh.
Most of you women are not good. Most of you women are not. I know. I'm stepping on some motherfucking toes tonight. I know. Go ahead and pull out your bong. Take one more, you know what I'm saying, long puff, because you're going to need it throughout this live stream. I'm telling you.
Look, do your thing, Cat Daddy. I even got the whole jar with me this time.
Look, as long as you've been, you know what I'm saying, knowing me and you've been hearing me talk, you know what I'm saying, I have been extremely consistent.